Hey, hey, what's up? This is the Major, and I am here with two major players, Mrs. and Mr. Williams. So we are here at their house, and we're just hanging out. They're going to cook us some food. I'm hungry. I can't wait. I held my appetite all day because I was looking forward to this. We are with the Williamses. Is that all right? The Williamses?
Yes.
And we are just going to hang out. We're just hanging out with them. We're going to taste some food, and then we're going to talk to them a little bit about their business, what they do, why they do it, and who they do it for. So stay tuned. We'll be right back. Don't move that mouse.
Chicken wings.
Okay,
so ma'am. Yes, ma'am,
please. Okay, hot wings. Okay. Woohoo! This bird is in my plate. Okay. All right. Got some wings there. Okay.
Macaroni and cheese.
Woo! Mac and cheese, my favorite. Now, I always said if you can make mac and cheese, you can cook. Okay, so we get some of this stuff out here. We're getting a little sample. Little bit there. I'll say something to you guys.
Okay.
All right. Okie dokie, now, what's next?
And then I made some hush puppies.
Ooh,
and then baked beans.
Woo-hoo, hush puppies. You know you got to sample everything. Take one of those hush puppies and some baked beans.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, just put a little here. Try not to be greedy for the camera, so.
Coleslaw.
Coleslaw. Ooh, I got some coleslaw. Okay. A little coleslaw. And
cornbread. I made some spaghetti because my, we call her mama and she's here, so
okay.
Just made us some.
Okay, I'm gonna just get a little bit of this.
You can try some too.
Okay.
And now this is banana pudding.
That's banana pudding. Now check it out. The banana pudding, we're gonna say that for dessert. See, I'm trying not to be greedy, but I'm just doing a little taste of everything. You know, like a little taste of soul. Anyway, don't worry about it. So anyway, we're gonna taste some stuff, and hey, I wanna bring in my other buddies. Come on, you guys. We got other military people in here, and they actually came. I hope you guys didn't think I was eating all this stuff by myself, because that would be gluttony, and gluttony is a sin. But anyway, okay, so we have, go ahead, tell the people your name. Specialist Green.
Specialist Quintez.
Quintez, and of course it's Marie, and it's my nice lady, come on. Don't do me like that, don't do me like that. Miss Blade, don't cut you. Get that camera off, Miss Blade. She don't cut you. So anyway, we're just here. We all gonna eat, and like I said, we're gonna eat some food. And once we finish with this, we're gonna sit down with Marie and her husband, and we're just gonna talk about their business and what motivated them and inspired them to actually get into this business and cook. Because you know they say a way to a person's heart is their stomach, and they already got me, and I ain't even ate yet. So anyway, we gotta eat some stuff. We're gonna take a quick commercial break. And we'll be right back. Hey, don't move that mouse. This is the Major on New Day Talk Radio, where every day is a new day. Sergeant Johnson.
Ma'am.
What is going on with these reflector belts?
I don't know. What are you talking about?
These soldiers are not wearing a reflector belt, but I don't understand.
Yes, ma'am. Our soldiers always wear their reflective belts.
Okay, let's do an inspection right now.
All right, ma'am.
Mm-hmm.
reflective belt.
Ma'am, it's in the middle of the day. We don't need a reflective belt.
All soldiers need a reflective belt. Promptly give me a reflective belt. Good job, Sergeant.
Oh.
Hi, this is Captain Lynette Jones, and we all should take time to reflect. That is why you should wear your reflective belt. According to the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration, over 4,000 pedestrians are killed each year in the United States. Most of those happen during the hours of darkness. And about 50% of those fatalities happens between the hours of 6 p.m. and 12 midnight.
This is a soldier walking with a reflective belt. And this is a soldier that's walking without a reflective belt. You see the difference, especially at night.
Use common sense. Don't be a dummy. Wear your reflective belt. It could save your life.
Hey, anyone got a reflective belt?
Y'all don't want to see that. But anyway, wow, the food was awesome. It was good. The mac and cheese, I'm telling you, I almost started crying, but you know, I'm just letting you know it was really, really good. So, wow, I mean, you guys put that spread together, like, how long did it take? Like 2 minutes?
Three? It takes about two hours or so to put the whole meal together.
Okay, 2 hours or so. Wow, that was really great. So, during this segment, we are actually going to try some dessert because, you know, I'm a little full. I'm a little greedy. But gluttony is a sin, but I'm not sinning yet. So we're gonna eat some of that stuff and try it out. But we're going to just talk to you guys about the business. So, you know, I want to know what made you guys start a catering service here in Kuwait of all places?
Well, it was started a couple of years back in support of the U.S. military.
Okay.
Mainly because I'm an ex-soldier myself, and I looked at it that we all should be able to get at least your mother's, a sample from your mother, from home, okay?
Right.
Which is the main reason
why we started. Only your mother knew how to cook.
Well, yes, only your grandmother,
right,
either
right.
one, somebody right. in your family, you know, when you're okay. doing your family reunions or, you know, anything of that nature, you usually try to look for something when you go abroad. What can attach me back to my home roots?
Right, exactly. I mean, the food is good. Like I was sharing with you earlier, Marie, I tasted your macaroni and cheese at someone else's event. I wasn't even invited, you know. But I was there and I ate and I was like, wow, who made this macaroni and cheese? I gotta get this lady's number. And months later, I got your number and here I am in your living room. Amazing. Okay, so how long have you been cooking? So let me back up a little bit, the backdrop of it, from my understanding that your mother-in-law, his mother, actually taught you how to cook.
Yes, ma'am, and that's the first step that I started to loving the American food, because I'm originally coming from Sri Lanka, the country that we do cook a lot of spicy food, and I learned how to cook from my age seven. We have learned how to cook at least the basic, you know.
So you've been burning for a long time.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, got it.
And then when I went to the States, I had a chance to stay with my mother-in-law for little while, about 3 weeks for me to get a job and come back over here. And I saw she was cooking and she didn't have no measurements or anything. She just throws up everything and
you know what?
She
know
just
what?
Cook and it Marie, comes out really good.
I got a secret for you. That's how we do.
Yeah.
That's how we do. I'm telling you, sometimes, I understand because my grandmother just throws. I'm like, what are you doing? How do you know what to put? They just feel it.
And
you know?
It was amazing, yes. And she's a really good cook. And that's what I did when I came back. I took some recipes from her and then came back here and tried. And then just started cooking. And then I was taking some food to work, where I work at, with the U.S. military. And then people were starting telling me then how good food was. Mm-hmm. And then some people was like, you know, they're bringing me money and say, I need you to bring me this dish tomorrow. And, then that's how it started.
Right.
And then I had a soldier that was working with me. His name was Sergeant Leonard, Jonathan Leonard. And he's the one who really pushed me to cook because he loved to cook. So we both together used to work in the container management, ITO. Wow. And he kind of, you know, pushed me to, encourage me to do the cooking. So we every time we have a party or something, you know, our soldiers get together, whatever, leaving here, and we used to cook. He cooked a dish and I cooked a dish, and then he bought me some chefing dishes to start this business.
Wow.
Yes, and he used to call me Mama, and he's like 23 years old soldier, a real nice person. And then he used to come over and, you know, helping us to cook, and then my husband, he loved to cook barbecue, and I love to cook the other part. So we kind of, you know, get together, and we started doing.
So you make it work. You know, it's nothing like cooking with the one you love. I'm telling you, it's nothing like cooking, up some food with the one you love. That's that's awesome. So a soldier actually took interest in what you were doing and decided to bring you some chafing dishes. That's pretty cool. So it is actually some good soldiers. You actually restored my hope in the military. No, I'm just kidding. So I want to ask you, you know, how you guys have this business, you cater. So how is business?
Business is really doing well, but we don't take, you know, like large amount. Mostly we serve the military, and then also the contractors here in at work. You know, we work for a contractor for here in Kuwait with the U.S. military. So it's really good.
Wow,
it's really good.
That's amazing. I mean, it's really good. I mean, food is something that we all need, and we want it, we need it, and all that great stuff. So that's pretty good. I mean, to take it and capitalize on it, and actually to make it available for the soldiers, I think that's really good. Hey, we're going to take a quick commercial break. We're here with Marie. I've got to get these names right. Man, you would think I would rehearse before this, but I did, you know. But I'm a little tongue-tied from food. Delicious. Hey, when we come back, we're going to talk to them a little bit more, and actually, we're going to have a little dessert. Stay tuned. We'll be right back. Don't move that mouse.
Hi, this is Captain Jones, and we should all take time to think about our personal safety. That is why you should travel with a battle buddy. Traveling with a battle buddy can potentially prevent you from being a victim of sexual assault.
You should always travel with a battle buddy. Never be out here by yourself. Anybody could be out here. Just come on. Come on, let's go.
Remember, travel with a battle buddy. Traveling with a battle buddy can prevent you from possibly being a victim of sexual assault. Sexual assault does not prevent life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Travel with your battle buddy.
This is the Major, and we're back. We are with Mr. and Mrs. Williams. That's probably easier for me, but I know their names, Marie and Doris. Haha, I got it right, man. But anyway, so we're here, we're talking about your business. You were talking about how your mother-in-law put you, you know, taught you how to cook, and how you guys came here, and a soldier was, you know, nice enough to help you guys out. So my next question is, how long have you guys been doing this?
It's been about...
about 3 years catering to Arab John, because we've been there about 3 years. Mm-hmm. Off and on, we've been doing it for about five, six years
total. Okay, so I got a question. How do you guys split the duties, husband and wife? You know, no, you cook the turkey. No, you make the dressing. No, you make the stuff. And how do you guys split the duties?
Mainly what we have is we try to do a gentleman ladies agreement to where she's in the kitchen doing the side dishes. Mm-hmm. And I'm always handling the smokers and the barbecue grills, which is pretty much a manly affair, because if you look back home, it's mostly your uncles and your granddads and your daddies, they are all over the grills.
But if you're
single,
mother's
always bringing the food out of the kitchen.
But if you're single like me, you do the grill, you do the chill, you do the wheel,
yes.
You do the oven.
Well,
you do all the cook. No,
that's possible too.
No, you're right, because when my uncle comes over, mm-hmm. I give him, hey, the grill is yours, and I'll do everything else mm-hmm. in the kitchen. So that's totally understandable. I totally agree. That's pretty cool. So, you actually, does it like, because I know you make a lot of desserts. You make the desserts and you make the food, or how does that work?
He mostly do the barbecue side, and then like fried fish, fried chicken stuff. We do in the kitchen. And he do the mostly smoked chicken, barbecue, ribs, and turkey. Mm. Last year we were really busy with serving the soldiers, camp building, and here in Abjam, mm-hmm. and the contractors.
Oh, wow.
He did all the work, and we had a little help here.
Mm-hmm.
And he do the mostly meat side.
Right. You know, I also noticed that you guys have a lot of food on your menu. Do you guys cook all that food?
Yes, on various occasions. It all depends on
when
certain people order certain dishes or whatever. We try to put the size to match the meat.
Okay.
Because
okay.
you can go down the menu and just pick at random,
mm-hmm.
but we'll try to put it together where it's an even flow with the starches, your vegetables, and your meats to try to blend it in.
Right, right.
A lot of people just go and pick because they like it. It's an eyesore. But mostly, if you look at a catering menu, which is most of these companies here, they have a set menu because they're going off of starch, meats, and vegetables.
Right, okay. So have you guys thought about starting a business like outside of Kuwait? Maybe like going to different states?
We're looking to go to Bahrain.
Bahrain?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
That should be taking place in about 6 months.
Okay.
And the main thing here in Kuwait is to try to get it set up to where we can go direct with support for the USO and the military.
Right.
A couple of bases we have here.
Okay. So let me ask you this. When you guys are not cooking, what do you guys like to do for fun? I mean, we all like to cook and cook, but you don't cook all the time. So what do you do for fun when you're not cooking?
Well, mainly she's going shopping.
I ain't mad at you right there.
And I usually go and we go down to the Avenues Mall, or we go to some of the prominent places in Kuwait to kind of relax a minute. Mostly we go for a walk on the beach.
So, okay, that's good. So let me ask you this. So, how long have you guys been married?
Oh, it's been 20?
It's 19 years.
19 years, and your husband can still hug up with you on the couch. Ain't nothing wrong with that. I ain't mad. I'm really not bad. That's really good. That's good. 19 years, and you guys have been doing this catering business pretty much 5 years off and on.
No, actually, we've been doing a little bit longer than 5 years.
No longer than 5 years, okay.
Yes, but we've been kind of going full scale at it for about 5 years.
Right, okay. So let me ask you, what is your vision? Where do you see yourself going with this business? I mean, you can cook, you can prepare food. Like you said, you want to go to Bahrain. But what's your vision for this company?
The main vision or the goal that we were shooting for was to support the military here in Kuwait.
Mm-hmm.
Well, actually support the military throughout the Gulf region.
Okay.
And if possible, then head to the Pacific Rim or wherever the U.S. Navy or the Army mm-hmm. is located at.
Right, and that's what I'm going to ask you. What do you do in the drawdown? You know, you hear people saying, the military is going to go away from Kuwait. We've been here a while, since the 90s.
Well, we've been here since 1990 is when the military.
Yes,
because I was in the first Gulf War.
That was for him. Yeah.
So, but the main goal is to actually support the soldiers while they're away from home, whether they're in Bahrain, Kuwait, or Qatar, or whichever part of this region. Mm-hmm. We're looking to just give them a home cooked meal.
Right, and you know the good thing about it is you're gonna always have soldiers abroad.
Mm-hmm.
So business, and if people like to eat, So oh, yes. You're not gonna run out. Now, if you was making toenail polish, you'd be out of business. No, I'm just kidding. Anyway. Hey, we're gonna take a quick break. When we come back, we're gonna have a little dessert. We actually got a chance to eat some food. Now we're gonna take some of that good old dessert, and I can't wait. Hey, what's up? This is the Major. We're back. Hey, while we took a break, I actually got me some dessert. So I'm going to taste this. See, I wanted to keep it real. I don't want to taste it off the camera and they say, ooh, she probably didn't even like it. But I'm going to show you. I haven't eaten any of this yet. So we're going to taste it right here while I'm actually talking to you. So this is your sweet potato pie.
Yes, ma'am.
All right. Now, you know what I'm going to tell you? I love sweet potato pie. I can eat a whole sweet potato pie by myself. As a matter of fact, my aunt, she makes me about 4 or 5 pies and I just eat one by myself. And I make sure the other one with everybody else. So, is this a dish that's also your mother-in-law taught you to make too?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh my God, this is good. This is really good. And this is, you put whipped cream on it?
Yes, ma'am.
This is really good. You know, I wanted to taste everything, but this is delicious. I love it. Okay. Wow. So, typically, when you do a soldiers order a lot of the sweet potato pie from you?
Yes, mostly we do the pies and cakes and stuff for Christmas and Thanksgiving. It's all pretty much by the time of the holidays, just beginning of the holiday season around the end of October, mm-hmm. and right after the Halloween. Mm-hmm. And we baked a lot of pies last year, Christmas, Thanksgiving.
You know, it kind of has a pumpkin-y taste to it, swag to it. So it's pretty good though. Now we're gonna taste the banana pudding. Now I love banana pudding. I used back in the day, just bragging. I might be interviewing for a job too. But back in the day, I used to make a banana pudding and the family loved it. It was, oh, you gotta make some of your banana pudding? You know, I said, well, I got a little waiting list. You know, it wasn't that long. I didn't have a long waiting list, so. Mm-hmm. Oh my God, that's good. This is good too. This is really good. I might eat this all over and over here. This is really good. So, okay. Mother-in-law taught you to make this one too?
Not really, no.
Oh, no! This that mama didn't teach! Oh, this is good though. I like this. And actually, one of the soldiers here, she said it was good too. That one over there. Mm-hmm. The woman behind the camera. So, this is, for me, this is where it all started. Red Velvet Cupcake. Because one of the soldiers actually ordered one of your cupcakes, and she, I said, well, you know, she's like, you want to taste this Red Velvet cupcake? It's really good. I'm like, yeah, okay, I guess I'll try it. So I'm gonna try it. Now, disclaimer: I might get a little cream on my nose, but that don't mean I'm a pig. Okay? Just like I remember. Really good. Actually, it's really good. So while I'm eating this cupcake, I'm gonna ask you guys another question. So, do you have children?
Yes, ma'am. We do have one daughter, and she's 26 years old.
Are you guys passing it on to her, or does she not know how to cook?
Well, she's a very good cook, too. Some dishes she do better than I do.
Really?
Like pastas, all the pastas she do cook a lot better than I do.
Okay.
I really don't like, personally, I don't like pastas, but she loves pastas, so she she cook pastas a lot. Not better than I do.
I have a confession to make. All day, I know you're supposed to eat your dinner first, but all day I have been waiting for these cupcakes. So that's why I'm going to eat all this cupcake, because it's really good. So your daughter, she cooks things. You say she can make some. Does she actually get involved with you guys' business and help?
Oh, yes. She comes and helps us to do, you know, when we're doing the cooking and stuff. But you know, we all working, and she works until 8 o'clock at night, and we all are contractors in the U.S. military.
Oh wow!
So, by the time she come home, it's already 9 o'clock at night, and she don't really have much time. But her day off, if I'm having anything going on, and she come over and help us.
Okay. Wow, I know somebody's gonna say she's doing an interview with her mouth full. Oh wow! I'm just keeping it real. reality TV. Don't they eat on reality TV?
Oh, yes, they do.
Yeah, they do. I'm telling you. So you guys are going to probably, hopefully, expand, like you said, to Bahrain, maybe. So do you see yourself just always being the one to cook, or do you plan on, like, maybe
no,
teaching somebody?
Well, we're doing it now, she and I. But once we go into a restaurant or a catering, a full-fledged catering or a mobile service, then we'll actually have the staffing to conduct the cooking and the preparation, food prep, delivery guys and all that. Basically, what we'll be doing is pretty much just going around to the different countries, setting up the different operations.
Right. Okay. So after 20 years of marriage, I'm being nosy now. After 20 years of marriage and all this cooking, do you guys cook for each other, like special meals, or how does that work? When you guys cook, do you just cook for him and he says, I'm not working, or do you just cook for her and she says, look, I'm taking the night off, baby, I ain't cooking nothing? Do y'all do that for each other?
Well, he come home late, he works in Camp Yoni, it's about 2 hours driving.
Oh, wow.
And I work at Camp Elfjan, it's about 20 minutes for me to come home. And where I'm coming from, my culture is not for let husband come home and cook for a woman. That's not my culture.
Can you say that again?
So we always have the meal ready for the man of the house. You know, he gets the first rice, first curries and everything. We prepare his table and like that. But now we've been married so long time, and then
you say, he just
comes
to
the kitchen and he comes in together. Because, you know, some parts he don't agree with what we're serving, and he said, no, I'm not handicapped, I don't want you to serve. You cooked and I will get my plate. But that's how we do, you know.
Wow.
We serve. So every day he come home, he
like
has
like king of the castle.
Well, his mother is just blaming me all the time. Said, don't spoil him.
Oh, wow.
But,
you say, look, honey, I'm his wife, okay? You his mama, I'm his wife. I was spoiled.
But he's not a person of, you know, come home and looking for everyday things, you know, be ready and stuff.
Right.
If we don't have anything cooked today and we just go out and eat, and some days we just do the, you know, walk out and stuff and then not eat much, like a simple salad or something.
Oh, wow.
But most of the dinner we prepare at home.
Mm.
Most of the days, every day dinner is at home.
Mm-hmm.
Curry chicken, rice.
So you guys ever eat out, like, anywhere?
We do, but we
when
don't
daughter,
like.
When she wants to go somewhere.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
But we don't like. Some days we get together, all three of us home, and we go for breakfast. But lunch or dinner at home every day.
Oh, wow. Man, see, some of these women from California, they need to take some notes from y'all. They want to go out and eat. They want to, you know, I mean, when we going to Red Lobster, I mean, they want to always take it out. So it's really, like you said, and then that, like, and I think it kind of helps you guys to be closer to, I mean, besides other things, being married, cooking together, and everything. But I like that kind of, you know, man of the house castle thing. But I don't know. I'm a little Americanized. I don't think I can do that. I mean, I'm probably already spoiled anyway. I mean, my chances are over. But anyway, we're not talking about me, we're talking about you guys. So, wow, that's great. So I just, so the name, Williams Catering Kitchen, was it the
Williams
name?
Kitchen.
Williams Kitchen. So
it's Williams Kitchen Limited. It's actually a corporation out of UAE.
Okay, out of UAE, okay. All right, is it any, do you guys have challenges doing business here as opposed to in the States?
Yes, the one challenge that we have is you know, they have quite a few home-based businesses in the U.S.
Yes.
But here, it's very rare. It's like pretty much unheard of to have home catering services
right.
or any kind of major cooking out of your kitchens because they mostly deal with fast food restaurants here.
Yes.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Then the law here actually states that you shouldn't even have a service where you provide food from your home.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, if you're not certified or whatever, licensed.
Right, but you're able to do it.
Yes.
Okay, that's good. Because I don't want to say I have a legal license. Business on myself.
No, you have to have a license.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah, limited company.
And that's good. But Maria, I got to commend you. Both your food is good. You know, if you guys' food was terrible, I would just probably just give y'all some of my personal advice and say, why don't y'all just give it up? I mean, it's really good. You provide this for the soldiers. And like I said, I heard about you through somebody else. And I thought it was amazing. So I want to thank you guys for welcoming me and these other greedy soldiers into your home and everything so that we can actually taste the food and everything like that and eat it because it's really good. So Oh, this is amazing. This is amazing. So you guys, y'all think y'all be like an old couple, like trying to scoot around the kitchen cooking and stuff like that? Y'all think y'all be doing that one day? Well, as long as you can, huh?
Probably so. We probably cooking as long as, you know, yeah, as long as somebody's willing to accept the meal coming forward, yeah, we'll probably be cooking every day for them.
Now, let me, you know, I met a couple of cooks, and I'm going to ask you, are you guys critical of other people's food when you guys go out to restaurants? Like, oh, my God, this could, you know, do you do that?
Well, yeah, sometimes, but, you know, if there is something good that we love to have and we go back there, you know, like mostly Indian dishes and stuff we love to have, and we go sometimes to the same restaurant and order the same food.
So, Dorisha, she's adapted pretty much to the American culture of food. Have you adapted to the Indian culture of food?
Somewhat, but I cannot handle the spices.
That's fine, yeah. I understand. I don't like spices.
You know, it caused my eyes to water.
Right. And, me too. My nose run and all that good stuff. So, curry.
Most of their food, like they ate the egg hope, the hopas today, they didn't eat the egg, but they did eat the egg hopas. That, they have a lot of those small, light meals that they have in Sri Lanka. It's pretty much a I guess if you're a vegetarian or anything like that, then you're fit into this culture pretty nice. They grow everything. They don't really it's not really a country where they have a lot of refrigerated items, you know, like frozen fish or frozen this or whatever, like in the U.S.
Okay.
It's pretty much kind of right out of the ground and into the pot.
Okay.
So it's almost like you're eating organic.
That's awesome. Hey, you know, I want to thank you guys for having me here and cooking and agreeing to do the interview, because I thought it would be a good idea just to show people what you guys do and get a taste of your food, even though they didn't get the taste that I did and some of these soldiers here. And we really enjoyed it. I want to say thank you so much.
And we thank you all for coming over here and giving us the opportunity to talk to your radio show, and thank you very much.
And you're so welcome. You're so welcome. Thank you. Hey, this is the Major. I'm majorly full right now, so I'm going to finish my dessert and probably get a to-go plate. It's okay for me to get a to-go plate.
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, yes.
And your food.
Ooh, I sure hate to take food when nobody told me I could take it. Hey, I hope you guys enjoyed this interview with Williams today. I had a great time, and the food was really good. So we're going to take a quick commercial break, and when we come back, we're just going to close out the show. Don't move that mouse. We'll be right back. Sergeant Johnson.
Ma'am.
What is going on with these reflector belts?
I don't know. What are you talking about?
These soldiers are not wearing a reflector belt. I don't understand.
Yes, ma'am. Our soldiers always wear their reflector belts.
Okay, let's do an inspection right now.
All right, ma'am.
It's in the middle of the day. We don't need a reflective belt.
All soldiers need a reflective belt. Promptly give me a reflective belt. Good job, Sergeant.
Hi, this is Captain Lynette Jones, and we all should take time to reflect. That is why you should wear your reflective belt. According to the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration, over 4,000 pedestrians are killed each year in the United States. Most of those happen during the hours of darkness. And about 50% of those fatalities happens between the hours of 6 p.m. and 12 midnight.
This is a soldier walking with a reflector belt. And this is a soldier that's walking without a reflector belt. You see the difference, especially at night.
Use common sense. Don't be a dummy. Wear your reflective belt. It could save your life.
Hey, anyone got a reflective belt?
Hey, so look, ladies, what did you guys think about the food?
The food was great.
That banana pudding.
Yeah, I agree.
Yeah,
that
banana
pudding
was great.
Yeah, it was great. It had
chicken. I thought the chicken was a little cold.
It was.
I'm just saying, everyone will call me.
I was looking around for my
day. But it was smoked. It was pretty good. Bread. What was it? What was the hookah?
No.
Hookah is smoked. No, I'm not listening. You said, so what is it? Maurice, what is it?
Hookah.
Hookah.
Yeah, it was
Hopus. H-O-P-P-S.
H-O-P-P-S. I was kind of impressed, but what y'all think when you said that you're going to have a good, y'all think it was going to be a spread like this?
Yeah. I thought it was really like samples.
You thought it was just samples?
Yeah. Like how you grabbed the beginning?
Yeah, we didn't know.
I didn't know, because she said
that. So I was like, we're supposed to take more.
Right, I didn't know, because she said, oh, we're going to have some food and stuff for you guys and stuff like that. So, hey, what's up? This is the Major, and we are just here rapping. We're talking about, this is called Empty Conversation. Hey, we got a cute guy in the background. Come back. We got somebody we're gonna bring up. We just kinda out here rapping. And
this is good. I'm not lying. This is good.
Yeah, what's your name?
Diane.
Who?
Diane.
Come on in. Diane, come on in. So that they can see you on camera.
This is one of the chicken wings.
Oh, you did the chicken wings.
You gotta come in the camera. We don't see you in the
camera. Come over here.
Oh, okay. What's your name again?
Guyon.
Yeah, let the man sit down. Sit down, Guyon. So, Guyon, so you made the chicken wings? So, let me try to talk about that. How old are you? Is this legal? So, you made the chicken wings. You smoked them and everything and barbecue? Yeah, let me tell you. Peacock chowder barbecue. Mm-hmm. You shy, huh? Okay, now we were just sitting here talking about the food. It was pretty good. It was actually good. You know, you won't have a hard time finding a wife because you can cook. You know, most American women, we like men to cook.
That's just being one of the women.
Oh! You know what? This is not one of those shows. It's not a dating show, I promise. Because that came out of the blue. I had no idea where that came from. But we're just going to keep rolling with the flow. So, let's say your name one more time.
Tell your name.
Guyon. Guyon. Oh, Guyon. Okay, that's a nice sentence you need. I'm Lynette. This is
Crystal.
Chrissy, and we know that's green over there. Ooh, look at that. She's so mad. So you from India?
Sri Lanka.
Sri Lanka. How you say it? Sri Lanka?
Sri Lanka.
Oh, okay. All right. Okay. So you're cooking and you're having a good time and everything and with the Williams and they, you know, teach you how to cook up and stuff. Yeah, you grow a shy. I'm going to have to kick you off with him because you're a little shy. No, but hey, thank you. But hey, this is the Major and we're just hanging out here having a good time. Hey, so thanks for tuning to the show today. And next week, I have no idea what I'm going to talk about, but I'll come up with something. Hey, take care. Eating some banana pudding. It's good too. After I got some more. Anyway, I'm gonna take a quick break and take another nap.